c'è l'amicizia, c'è il gioco, c'è l'invidia, c'è l'amore e c'è anche la morte. Perciò è una lezione di vita, la Bohème.
La gente lo que va a ver cuando venga a la ópera es la buhardilla de los bohemios, la buhardilla parisina donde viven los cuatro amigos bohemios. Y todo se va a desarrollar en escenarios absolutamente reales y fieles a la historia original.
He wanted to update the production to 1930s, where there is a huge body of photo work, real people in real situations, particularly the work of Brassai and Cartier-Bresson and Brassai, who are two big photojournalists who were taking pictures around Paris in the 20s and 30s.
Serve un controllo vocale, ma serve anche tanto cuore, perciò questa è la difficoltà di Puccini, insomma.
Es una dificultad rítmica y sobre todo de expresión. Es una escena en la que cuenta una historia y debe ser contada muy claramente, jugando mucho con los colores, con el ritmo, con el texto. Ahí radica la dificultad del área de Schaunard.
He likes that everyone says when we're rehearsing here in the rehearsal studio, they say, "Oh, there's not enough space. We feel so awkward. I can't push past him. And you told me I have to go to the kitchen and get her a glass of water, but he's in the way." And Jonathan's argument to that is that's how it feels when you're in the room with a dying person. You don't know what to do with yourself. You don't know where to put yourself. You have to say, "Excuse me, can I push past you to get a glass of water?" He likes that.
For example, in Act Three, you have the whole scene about Musetta in the bar, and you see her even during the duetto with Marcello and the duetto with Mimì, and this I have never seen before. So you see her playing with a sailor and a little bit dancing and flirting, and this you never see in all the production. You have so many people on stage, and you have to enter and to play like everything is okay. So this is very difficult because right away she's like, "Viens, Loulou, viens, Loulou."
Para la gente que no ha venido nunca, que no ha ido nunca a la ópera, la Bohème es desde luego el título ideal para iniciarse en la ópera.
Tanta musica dentro, tanto cuore, che è difficile che in Bohème nessuno non si commuova.